Welcome friends to a session of finite element methods for fluid dynamics. We are going to begin with some methods for approximations. So we'll start with the ordinary differential equations, and I am going to introduce some very simple methods to show you how we can approximate and get numerical solutions to these ordinary differential equations. Let's first start with the first order differential equation. So let's pose the problem. The problem is very simple. So we are going to solve dy by dx is given as a function of x and y. Okay. Y is only a function of x. So that's why we get an ordinary differential equation. This has to be solved along with an initial value. So the initial value is that y at x equal to 0, or I'll call it x 0, is y 0. So we need to get solution to this problem. It's a very simple equation, and many a times it is possible to get an exact solution or an analytical solution to it. So let me draw a picture for you. That's my x axis, that's my y axis, and in fact let me also mark here, this is x 0 and the value here is y 0, and my function may look something like this. Okay. So this is my function y, and then the slope of this at any point, if I take any point x, y, then the slope of this is dy dx, and this is given as f x, y. So the problem is very simple. Given the slope, I need to calculate what is the function itself. Okay, extremely simple problem. So there are many ways of doing it. Let me show you one possible way. The first approximation that we will make is that instead of getting a solution at all values of x, we are going to be talking about getting solutions at some discrete values of x. So we'll first discretize. In the sense that we'll say that we are interested in the function at x0, x1, x2, x3, so on. If I can find the value of y at these discrete values of x, I am happy. So I can actually mark those values here. For example, this could be x1, this could be x2, and so on. And all I need to do is estimate what are the values at these different x. Given that at x0, I already know the value y0. Okay. So need to find y0, y1, y2, y3, and so on. The next step that I do is I use a Taylor series expansion. So I ask myself that if I know y at x, what is y at x plus h? So I use the Taylor series for this and say this is y at x plus h times y prime x plus h square by factorial 2 y double prime x plus h cube by factorial 3 y triple prime x and higher order terms. Now I can use this equation to actually extract or estimate what is the value of y prime x. So I can rearrange and I can write from this equation that y prime x can actually be given as y x plus h minus y x divided by h, and then I am going to get some other terms. For example, this one would be h by 2 y double prime x. This term here is going to be h square by 6 y triple prime x, and of course higher order terms. This already gives me a template to estimate the derivative. So suppose I make an approximation. And my approximation is that let y prime x be actually given as y x plus h minus y of x divided by h. Then this quantity here actually becomes my error. So this is error in the estimate of y prime x. Mind you, because this is a function of one variable, I am actually saying that y prime is same as dy by dx. So let me just put here a small note that y prime x is actually the same as dy by dx. Just a notation. Okay. So now I already have a numerical method. So what I am saying is, if I knew the value of y at two points which are close enough and they are separated by a distance h, then the difference in these two values divided by the distance h can give me an estimate of the first derivative of y, and the error that I incur is of this kind. So what does this error depend on? Well, the error actually depends on h. As well as it depends on the higher order derivatives. By higher order derivatives, I mean the second order derivative of y, the third order derivative of y, and so on. In fact, I could say that if I had to find the error in the differential equation, so let E of x denote the error in my differential equation. So I can actually substitute my y prime in the original differential equation, and I would get the following. So Ex is actually the error, which is dy by dx minus f of xy. This is the error. And I already know this is the formula for dy by dx. So if I plug this in, then I can see that this implies that my error in x is given as simply h by 2 y double prime x plus
h square by 6 y triple prime x plus
higher order terms. Okay. And this I could approximate as simply h by 2 y double prime, and this x I can call as some kind of an x bar, where x bar belongs to the interval x and x plus h. It is somewhere in between. So, what I am able to show is that my error is actually of the order of h. Okay. So, error is of the order of h. That means, as I keep reducing my h, okay, I keep reducing the sampling distance, then I can get a better and better approximation to dy by dx, and that makes sense. Okay, if I had a curve, this is y, this is x, this is x, this is x plus h, then we already know that the slope of this line or this curve is actually the difference between the y values divided by the difference in the x values, and in the limit that h tends to 0. And that is what we are seeing, that the error actually goes to 0 as h goes to 0. But the other important thing is y double prime. So, by using the Taylor series expansion, I have kind of implicitly assumed that this is a smooth function and y double prime exists and it has some bounded values. Okay. So, we will discuss these things a little bit later, but what I want you to keep in mind right now is that my error is directly proportional to h. So, this implies this is a first order method. In fact, if error varies as order of h to the n, then n is called the order of the method. Okay. So, here we have a very simple methodology to estimate the first derivative and thereby get an error in the differential equation itself in its numerical form, and that turns out to be a first order approximation. So, let us summarize what we have so far. So, we are trying to solve this problem y prime is f of x y and y at x 0 is y 0. And I have been able to get an approximation that my y prime is actually given as an approximation as y x plus h minus y x divided by h. And the error E is the error that is of the order h. I can now use this for this solving this differential equation, and I would get the following, that y at x plus h minus y of x at h, this is f of x y. And now I can actually, or maybe I should just put a sign that says it is an approximation, and from this I should be able to estimate that my y x plus h is simply given as, again as an approximation, y of x plus h times f of x y. This is a stencil or a template that I can use to estimate x plus h. So, the method that I get out of it is called the Euler's method. And as I said, this is a first order method. Let us see how it works.
So this is my x, this is my y, and let's say this is my x0.
So I'm going to introduce x1, x2, x3, x4, and so on. And these values are x1 is given as x0 plus h, my x2 is given as x1 plus h, which actually is given as x0 plus 2h. Similarly, my x3 is x2 plus h, and this I can simplify to x0 plus 3h, and so on. So, the method starts with using the initial condition, the initial value. So, at x0, the value is y0. Okay. And now I would like to estimate what is y1.
So, y1 is actually y at x0 plus h, which is going to be given as y at x0 plus h times f of x0 y0. Okay.
So, you can see I am able to get y1 simply as y0 plus h times f evaluated at x0 y0. And once I am able to calculate the value of f1 here, sorry, the value of y1 here, now I can jump to what is the value at x2 and get that. So, I can generalize that my stencil is that y at x plus h is simply given as y at x plus h times, in fact, I can call this as xn, and this would be xn and h times f of xn yn. So, what I have done is I have been able to recalibrate my problem, which was given in terms of a differential equation, to simply an algebraic system. So, I have replaced, so I have been able to replace a differential with a differential equation with a difference equation. This is very symptomatic of what is done in a finite difference method, that you replace all the derivatives with differences, finite differences. Okay. So, that is the stencil for you. Can we do better? So, the question we can ask is, and the answer is of course, yes. So, let me take you back to what the original problem was and what we have done numerically to it. So, this was my original curve, and what the numerical, the Euler method has done is, so it started with x0, and to get to the point x1 and get this value of y1, we actually use this stencil. So, we said y at x1 is simply y at x0 plus h times the slope, but the slope has been calculated at this value. Okay. In fact, you know that the slope should have been a weighted average of the different values of x. So, in fact, this is an approximation we have made, that to estimate the value of y, we just used the slope at the initial point. So, now what we can do is, we can get a better estimate of slope. For example, I could say, well, when I go from point 0 to point 1, I should look at not just the slope at 0, I should look at slopes both at 0 and 1 and perhaps take an average of that. But the problem is, I do not know the point y1, and in fact, I will need that to estimate the slope at point 1. So, we can use something called a predictor multicorrector method. So, we use a predictor corrector method. So, the suggestion is, let y star n plus 1 be given as y n plus h times f at x n y n. So, this we are estimating from the Euler's method, the first order Euler's method. Okay. But now we are going to do another iteration. Now that we know y star, I can actually estimate what is the slope based on this y star value. So this is the predictor step. And now I follow this up with a corrector step. And in that step, what I do is, I say the real value of y n plus 1 is going to be y n plus h times the average slope. So, the average slope I am going to use as f at x n y n plus the slope at x n plus 1 and y n plus 1 star, this divided by 2. Okay. So, what I have done is that I first use the slope here to jump to the value at x 1, and once I know the value here, I can estimate the slope at this and then use the average of the two slopes to again come back and integrate from the previous value of x. Okay. So, this is supposed to be more accurate. So, this is more accurate than the first order Euler method, because I have invested more, I have used more information, and the slope now is estimated in a slightly better way. In fact, one can show that this method is second order accurate. So, this we often call as the modified Euler method.